Hi everyone, I'm Brian with the Scientist in Every Florida School program. And in this edition of Science Segments, I'm excited to connect you to a scientist to help you learn about weather. Who are you and what is your title?
My name is Dr. Andrew Kren. I'm an assistant scientist with the University of Miami.
What do you research and why is that important?
What I research specifically is ways to improve the prediction of hurricanes, both their track and their intensity. The way we do that is we fly drones and aircraft both into the hurricane and above the hurricane to eventually take observations around the storm to improve where it's going to go, how strong it's going to be. And that's important because if we can predict in advance where it's going to go and how strong it might be, that will save lives and property in the long run.
Can you briefly describe how global patterns such as the jet stream or ocean currents influence local weather?
Sure. Let me show you a PowerPoint here of those results. So this is basically a picture of the United States kind of meandering between the upper part of the Midwest and the southern part of the US is an area where we call the jet stream. When the jet stream meanders from time to time. When it meanders south, which means it brings in colder air from Canada down into the US, that is going to impact more temperatures. That's going to impact the temperatures across parts of the US. However, when the jet stream shifts north, which means it moves more into Canada, for the US, an example, you're going to bring warmer air in from Mexico. Another example here is this is an image basically looking at the globe, but focused on the United States and North America. The jet stream can take a variety of different patterns and looks to it. This is basically showing the jet stream, the colors denote the strength of the wind connected to the jet stream. So your red colors are your strongest part of the jet stream and the flow. And the jet stream is strongest in the wintertime and it's weakest in the summertime. And so in the wintertime, you get more different variations in the jet stream as opposed to the wintertime. And that's going to lead to more dramatic temperature changes as the jet stream moves north and south. This is a satellite animation, not from today, but actually from a couple weeks ago, showing you how the atmosphere moves. And that's all connected to the jet stream. This is looking over the US, and you can see basically air that is coming south out of Canada into the upper part of the Midwest. That is bringing colder air south. Conversely, if you look over the southeastern US, such as around Florida, you have flow that's coming in from the southwest, such as from the Gulf of Mexico up into the southeastern US and parts of northern Florida, the panhandle. And that's bringing in warm and moist air. And so all of the all of the weather patterns are driven by this jet stream and how that impacts both temperatures and precipitation. Depends where the jet stream is, as that will play an important role on the weather for that particular location. Now moving on to ocean currents. So briefly, this is basically a map picture of the globe showing you that you have different ocean currents throughout different regions of the ocean. The Pacific Ocean here, you have different ocean currents that transport both warm air from the equator to the poles and also cold air from the polar regions into the mid-latitudes. Same thing over the Atlantic Ocean, we have different ocean currents. One of the prominent ocean currents off of Florida is known as the Gulf Stream. It transports warm air from the tropics up into the North Atlantic region. And depending on what kind of ocean current is located on which particular part of your region, such as if you're on the west coast of California, you have basically a cold current that is off the coast of San Francisco, for example. And because that ocean water is colder than the nearby land, that temperature difference between the ocean and the land is going to moderate temperatures to be cooler than they would be if the ocean was warmer. Conversely, if you're over, say, Florida, you're transporting warmer ocean water into Florida, off the coast of Florida. And that's going to keep temperatures relatively moderate throughout the season, both in the winter and in the summer. So that's a brief example of answering that question for you.
Thank you, Dr. Kren, and thank you all so much for watching. We will see you next time.